Well, I think the way Tom Blackburn made the thing happen is what makes it special. The very first year of the field house, they established it, and we've been feeding off that table ever since.
Don Donaher saw it all happen, first as a player and eventually as the Flyers head coach. While Blackburn led UD to that first NIT title, it was Donaher who took the program into the arena in 1969.
It was one thing to sell out the field house, but then it was another thing to go over to the arena with a more than double capacity and sell that thing out. And Tom Ferrix was the architect of it. And he believed in it, and he sold the administration on it. They were a little wary of the investment, but we went over there and more people came.
It wasn't yet the big dance in 1967, but the Flyers were in the NCAA's title game, losing to Lou Alcindor and UCLA in the finals. In 1984, Donaher's Cinderella team took down LSU, Oklahoma, and Washington before losing to eventual national champion Georgetown in the Elite Eight.
You know, you got back here, it was like that first NIT, you know, I mean, the town was on fire. And of course, we relived that just this past winter.
30 years after the Elite Eight run by Roosevelt, Chapman and company, Archie Miller's third team went on a similar run earlier this year. Dayton beat Ohio State, Syracuse, and Stanford to once again end up as one of the Elite Eight teams left in the NCAA tournament.
Grandfathers to fathers to sometimes their sons and daughters, there's generations of people that have witnessed and experienced those successes that are still in this town. And when you go through a run like we had this past season, to watch the 84 class of people, not players, but the 84 graduates and some of the people that were on this campus 30 years ago be able to come back down to the campus after a win, to me that was something that was very, very unique you don't get a chance to see.
You also don't get a chance to see a team inducted into a Hall of Fame very often, but there's no question Daytonians believe that this program deserves the honor.
Dayton basketball, I've used this before, it's like a relay team. I mean, the old-timers that started it when the game was invented, they ran a lap, and then the Blackburns ran a lap, and our guys ran a lap, and now we got the anchor team going.
To have a program inducted into a Hall of Fame, to me, speaks volumes of how important it's been for a long time. Some of the greatest players that have ever played here are some of the greatest players that have played the game. And I think that those moments, those impactful moments, are one of the reasons that a star is deserved.
The Dayton Flyers are being recognized for 111 years of outstanding basketball and for encouraging one of the best fan bases in the country. Congratulations, Flyers.